Floor plan level 2, select one inverted T-beam, right click, select all instances, entire project, double M, specify center point. Go to 3D view, it will be mirror all of the beams to the opposite side, shaded HD. Now floor plan level 5, double T-beam, so go to floor plan level 5, structure, beam, double T-beam. 818. Place one beam vertical for the ramp. So I'll be place one beam. Go to 3D view, select the beam. Change the placement. Now go to the south elevation, measure the distance, minus 1 foot 3 inch, end offset minus 1 foot 3 inch, so your beam goes to the inside. Now go to 3D view, this is your one slanted beam. Now next is floor plan level 5, quarter 1 section. Select the beam, move, copy, multiply. Select, copy, now select the floor, use the command join, okay, so it will be joined the element. Now similarly you have to repeat the process for all of these three drives. So go to floor plan level 5, beam command, BM. So this is your one beam, BM, center, to the center. Go to 3D view. Now at here you have to use the start offset as well as end offset. So go to the south elevation, select this beam. Now measure the distance, so distance command minus 3 feet, so select start offset minus 3, minus 2 feet 9. Feet. Okay, and end offset minus 4 feet. Up to here, in your view. Measure distance. Minus 1 foot 3 inch. End offset. Distance. Minus 3 feet. Okay, so go to 3D view. Now select join command. Okay, open floor plan level 5. Select the section, copy, open section view. Select inverted 1 T beam. Click on copy, Similarly, you do repeat the process throughout. Okay, so this beam, all of the beams is going from level 4 to level 5. Okay, so you do repeat.